Good morning, folks. This week, we get to play around with electron beams and get them to do some really neat, fun things. Before we can play around with them, though, we need to get the equipment set up. So let's go ahead and turn the lights on. Let's take a look at how we get this piece of equipment set up. Now, really important here is that we do connect all the wires correctly. Because if you miswire this electron beam tube, it's really easy to burn out the filament inside of it. At which point, you've now destroyed a $700 piece of equipment, and they're not terribly easy to replace these days. First off, I want you to notice that the wires themselves are fairly color-coded, and that just makes it hopefully a lot easier, a lot quicker to set up the wires. So let's go ahead and work from the inside out. We want to use the green wires to connect our AC voltage to the filament. And that's what's going to power the little filament in the back, get it really toasty so that we can boil some electrons off. Next thing we want to do is grab the blue wires, and there is a black one and there is a red one. We're going to attach that to the black and the red connections on the power supply and the electron beam apparatus. That's going to generate the accelerating voltage, the electric field that pulls electrons off of the filament itself. Last, but certainly not least of the things that we'll be using, is the yellow wires, which we're going to attach to our power supply where it's yellow. And this is going to drive a current through the Helmholtz coils, this set of coils here. And those coils, when there's current running through them, are going to create that magnetic field that's going to be messing around with our beam of electrons. We do have a couple extra wires here if you want to use your multimeters. We can use those a little bit later on in the lab to get a more precise measurements of the voltage and the current that we've applied to this electron beam apparatus. That'll help us get much better calculations with less uncertainty to them. Two things that we need to be really careful about when we're working with this lab. One thing is, remember your right-hand rule for forces. All right, again, there's a couple different versions that we'll be playing around with. Make sure that you know your instructor's version and that you stick with it. The other thing that we need to warn you about is this electron beam apparatus is shooting out electrons. A lot of people forget that. It's going to be super useful. Then go ahead, turn on your power supply and let it warm up for about 30 seconds or so. Now, there's a couple cautions I want to give you about the power supply itself. We want to make sure that the accelerating voltage is kept to right around 100 volts or such. If you turn it up too high, then the circuit breaker on the inside is going to trip, and you'll need to turn everything all the way back down and push this button on the side to reset that circuit breaker. Other thing to be concerned with, too, is how much current we're drawing out of the coils. We're only going to use about up to 2 amps or so when we're running current through the Helmholtz coils. And so make sure that we keep a lid on that, definitely. If this circuit breaker blows, there's a switch hiding on the back side here. Once it's warmed up, we can take another look at how the electron beam works. We'll show you some stuff here in the dark. We're going to do a couple different activities. One is to take the north pole of the magnet, bring it in directly from the front, and see what that does to the electron beam. Then we'll flip it around, make a prediction about what happens if we bring the south end in. Then last, but certainly not least, we're going to use the bar magnet and pull it in directly from the side, parallel to the beam, right along its same path. After playing around with that, that's going to give us a lot of nice right-hand rule practice. We want you to make sure that you get rid of this bar magnet, get it back to the center of the room, out of the way, because it creates a very large magnetic field, and that magnetic field can affect our relatively precise measurements that we're going to be making here. All right. When we get around to playing with this, we can increase the current going through our Helmholtz coils. That's going to bend our electron beam. We can do a couple different things. We can make measurements of the radius. We can vary our accelerating voltage. We can vary the current through the Helmholtz coils. One of the things we're also going to have you do is gently grasp the base of this tube and rotate the electron beam to different angles. You can actually make this beam shoot straight forwards, which is pretty darn fun. But we're going to ask you to at least just slightly turn it about 10 degrees forwards from that horizontal region. And of course, when you're done and ready to take measurements, we'll want to turn it nice and sideways there. One of the measurements we're going to need to make here is going to be fairly precise, and it can be a little hard to do for this next spot. So what you'll want to do is line yourself up, look through the electron beam at its reflection, and if you look straight through it at its reflection, then you know you're perpendicular to the beam and perpendicular to the mirror. And so take a look through there, try to figure out what distance can you measure for the radius of the electron beam itself. You'll want to do that with both sides, then take the average of the two values in order to get a good measurement there. Then we can move on to the cathode ray tube, which is also an electron gun back here shooting electrons. In this case, they're hitting a phosphorescent screen. Now this has the exact same connections that we worked with earlier. It's got color-coded blue and green ones. And we're working with, there's yellow on the coil around the outside. And then this also has a set of red plugs on the back side, which we're going to use connecting up to our desktop power supply in order to apply a very finely controlled voltage to the deflection electrodes. We've got a whole bunch of really fun activities. You get a chance to play with magnets, see how they affect the electron beams, and hopefully you get a charge out of this.